Hallelujah! Happy Mother's Day to all of you mothers who are here, those of you who are watching us online. It's a beautiful day here in Colorado. Kind of cool, but it's nice. It's nice. So we want to be comfortable today and join us and enjoy the Lord's Day. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen?
Amen.
You know, there is something about a mother's prayer. So you mothers who are out there, do not ever think that God is not answering your prayers. If you have some children who are acting wild, do not worry. Keep praying. God has a time. And when that time comes, they will come to the Lord. You know, sometimes when we start praying for those people in our lives, actually things sometimes they get worse and you think, oh, are these prayers going anywhere? But take heart. We serve a great God. He answers prayers. Amen? So today we are going to go in the Word of God. I'm not going to be talking about mothers. You know, some people here, they spoiled us this morning, you know, with Proverbs 31 woman. We got flowers. We got presents. Abba spoiled us this morning with beautiful worship. Oh, thank you, Father. Thank you so much. So I want to talk to us this morning about the power of the Word of God. Because it is powerful. It is a tool that we have to be able to overcome any obstacles in our lives. And it is guaranteed. Amen?
Amen.
I mean, the Word of God in Hebrew 4 verse 12 says, for the Word of God is alive and powerful. It is sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing or cutting through or between soul and spirit, between joint and marrow. It expresses or exposes or judges our hearts or our innermost being and desires. Do you see how powerful the Word of God is? The sword of the Word of God. So in order for the Word of God to work, it's like a sword. The sword is not going to go anywhere if you're not holding it and use it. If you hold the sword in your hands, you are going to do this probably. Or if there is a giant, you need to stray down here. You're going to stray it this way. The same way, the Word of God, we can read it, we can know it. But if we do not apply it, it's not going to do anything. And did you hear what the Word of God says? It's a two-edged sword. So you cannot say, well, it's sharp on its side, but maybe the giant on its side is too big for the Word of God to stray it. No. Both sides, front, everywhere, it is sharp, and it can overcome anything in our lives. So the Lord was visiting with me this week, and he was showing me how actually we don't know how powerful his word is, because if we understand how powerful the Word of God is, we are able to overcome anything. But sometimes, you know, we want microwave style stuff, but God doesn't work that way. So we have to know his word. And one of the things in his word, he is a patient God. That's one of his character. He is patient. So as his children, we have to be patient. If we speak the word and we don't see it come to pass, we just hold on to it. Remember? A sword, you have to hold to it. Once you have used it, believe. At the appointed time, it's going to work. Amen?
Amen.
I mean, you know, I'm so amazed. And I'm going to be giving examples to see that we're just not talking about just things. It works. The Word of God works. You know, the Word of God also in Matthew, Jesus was talking to the disciples and he was telling them, heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will not pass away. Do you see how guaranteed we are when we hold on this word that will never pass away? You know, God is going to create a new heaven, new earth. The present things will pass away, but this will never go away. So you better Bakorab and Horodon tied to that sword. Do not let it go down thinking this problem is too big. Because there's nothing too big for our God. He's mighty. Amen. Are you excited this morning?
Yes.
Oh, I feel like jumping. Thank you, Jesus. We are to pay attention to the word of God. We are to really believe that it is true because it is actually true. Amen? Amen. So this week, this is how it started. Somebody texted me and they said, they were asking me a question about fasting. I said, oh, my sister, I have a question. If you can hear, I've been fasting, but what do you do when you're fasting, but your stomach is really hard? It's not even in your stomach. Your back is so hurting and you cannot bend down. And then, you know, it's very smart always to not speak right away and hear what God has to say, because I can give my ideas, but what does God has to say? So immediately, I started to put my finger on my phone and I was listening to what the Lord was saying. Usually when you're fasting and the Lord has asked you to fast, the enemy is not going to want you to continue fasting. So he's going to bring all this kind of problem. You know, we've been fasting and I tell you the last fast we have done, I never felt like that before. I almost felt like fainting. My back was hurting. I was like, what is this? So the enemy didn't want us to fast. And this sister of mine, she was just having a hard time. And then the Lord said, what does my word say? When Jesus was in the wilderness fasting and the enemy came to him, what did he say? Well, in the word of God says, man shall not live by bread alone. See? It's not by the potluck in the kitchen. It's not what's in the refrigerator, because you can give yourself a word saying, I believe the Lord is releasing me because this is too hard and he loves me. He doesn't want me to have my back hurting. He doesn't want me to faint, because for the Lord's sake, I'm going down a town to minister. How can I minister if I'm faint? But who told you to fast in the first place? So we have to have discernment to see who is at work. But the Lord pointed me back to the scripture. If you have a mountain, speak to it. How do you speak to it? Use the word of God. Amen? Man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. So actually, when I started to say that, to write that down, the Lord started talking to me. Do you actually realize how powerful that is? Because my word is true. When I say something, it is because it is truth and nothing can take it away. If you believe it, it is going to work. Amen. You say the scripture, you believe it, and before you know it, if you keep meditating, well, devil, out. The word of God tells me I shall not live on bread alone, but on every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. You keep meditating it. So this is true. That's what I believe. I'm sorry, devil. My back, I don't mind if it hurts for a little bit, but my word is going to go through. It's piercing right now. I'm holding my sword. I'm swinging it around. And before you know it, you'll start to feel better. You will start to gain strength because you used what? The power of the word of God. This is truth. It's not going to go away. Amen?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It's amazing. Then the Lord started showing me different scriptures about things in the Bible. When you are facing something and you don't know if you can get to the top of the mountain, always ask the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, what is the word I can stand up now? You know, there is one that everyone knows. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. They are treating me so harsh. Lord, you teach us to love our enemies, but it's a little hard. Can you please help me? And then when you say, well, you know what? But your word says, I can do all things through you. So I can love, I can forgive. You are using the word of God. The message today is simple. The word of God works. But most of the time we don't actually believe it. We say it, but when we start believing the word of God and then an hour goes by and it's not working, then we start saying, you know what? Maybe it's not the day, but that's not true. The word of God is going to work if you trust in the Lord. Greater is you who is in the world, who is in you, than the one who is in the world. The world is the devil trying to tear us down each and every day. But he who is in us, Jesus Christ, is stronger and mighty to carry you from where you are falling off and hold you up to the top of the hill and hold you and tell you, my daughter, my son, we can make it. Amen? So whatever problem, whatever issue you are facing in your life, here from Genesis to Revelation, there are answers. There are answers. I have tested the word of God. I actually like to test the word of God to see if it works. I know it works, but I like to have fun with God. So, okay, Lord, you say this works, so let's see. And then I'm so amazed how faithful God is. Amen? I have a son, he runs. He runs long distance, so sometimes it's endurance. And I have taught him, when your body gives out, you need to start meditating on the scripture. If you start meditating, I will run and not grow weary. I will walk and not faint. Guess what? Your body is going to start responding to the word of God because it is alive. It is sharper. It's not. What's the opposite of sharp?
Dull.
Dull. It's not dull. It's sharp. It's not gonna, it says here, it pierces through the joints, the bones. I mean, you don't have to hit it twice with the word of God. It is so powerful, amen? Woohoo, are you excited this morning? I love his word. Proverbs 4:20 and 22, say, 4:22 says, my son, pay attention to what I say, what God say. Here, there is the word he speaks through the written word. There is also a word he speaks to you face to face. But most of the time, what God tells you face to face is not going to contradict his word. He says, pay attention to what I say. Turn your ear. When somebody says, turn your ears, like mom is calling boys up there, and when they don't listen, you say, pay attention. So this is what God is telling us. Turn your ear to my word. Pay attention. Do not let them go out of your sight. So that means sometimes you may not see it, but you can start imagining it. If you are seeing yourself preaching in a stadium because God has called you and told you that in the future you will preach to thousands and thousands of people, hey, imagine that. Keep it in your sight. Just stand up here, find a pulpit, and start envisioning 1,000 people in front of you and start preaching. Hallelujah. Actually, what we don't know is that the angels and the host of heaven and saints, they all come down and start listening to our sermon. Amen. And maybe God can open your eyes and you start seeing. So you're building, he's building your faith. Do not let my words out of your sight. Keep them into your heart. Treasure the word of God. That's the only one that thing that's gonna hold you up when you are down. For my words, they are life to those who find them, and healing to their whole body. Amen? Do you see how powerful the word of God is? You know, it's funny. In my neighborhood, a couple of months ago, I started seeing, we have this next door email thing when our neighbors are emailing if they need help or if there's something that is going on. So there is a gas station in my neighborhood, and it looks like somebody have gone into the gas station and put something in there, the credit card reader, and was coming, credit cards. People will be going to buy gas, and they look there, their bank, it looks like they're card was used somewhere, it's like twice. And I saw that. I was like, oh, there's no accident. I was like, well, devil, you got the wrong neighborhood. This is my area. I govern here with my God, so we are going to kick you out. You cannot be stealing people's money because this is my neighborhood. I don't care if there's no one who's praying, but I'm here, and greater is God in me than the devil who is using you, using these people to steal people's money. And I said, no. So I start going after those demons who are pushing these people to steal. Guess what? A week and a half ago, I saw that they have found a credit card scheme thing, and they have cut the person who's been doing it. Do you see?
Amen.
God is powerful. You have power in you. You just have to believe, because greater is God in you than the devil in this world. When I get home to my house, it doesn't matter if my children didn't pray. It doesn't matter if my husband is coming from work and there are demons that are attached to him because of the presence he's been. No, when I get there, it's my house, and greater is God in me that lives here in me. So it doesn't matter. The light in me does not live with darkness. So therefore, I expel you out of my house, in every room, on every object, and everything. In every room, in the name of Jesus, not only in my house, out of my property, out of my street, and out of my neighborhood, in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
You gotta believe that God has given us the power to tread upon serpents, scorpions, and over all, not just some.
Amen.
Oh, I'm getting fired up. Shall my enemies harm me? Well, I stand in a gap for my family. If they didn't pray, I'm here. They came here through my womb, so I take responsibility. I cleanse them from all those demons. I repent for their sins. And do I see God work? I'm giving you real examples. I'm not lying. God lives in my house. I have a prayer room, and I have called it the encounter room. So even if the kids, the friends have worked in the house and they don't know God, when I get home, this is actually the instructions that the Lord has given you. And this is an encouragement for you. Do not worry if they don't believe in your house. You have the greater one, God Almighty, living in you. And he's more powerful than any demon that they can bring in the house. So use that power. That's the word of God. Amen?
Amen.
Woohoo! So how about prayer? How about when the flesh is telling you, you know, you've been at work all day, you're tired, so let's just soak. But you know what's going to happen if you just soak, and you soak for a long time, if you're not in the presence of God, you're going to fall asleep. But the flesh have tricked you, and you forgot what the word of God said. What does the word of God say? Where the Spirit alone gives eternal life. But the flesh, it profits me nothing. Right. Does not help at all. So if the flesh is tired, kick it out. Tell the flesh, well, you profit me nothing. Why should I be hanging out with you? So when I get to prayer, you know, I'm guilty of this thing. Sometimes I give in a flesh, but God does not want us to give up.
Right.
I tell the flesh, you know what? You feel tired. You've been out watching the kids running, and you know, as a mom cheering, it's a long day. You only slept 4 or 3 hours. So you have excuse. You can just relax. Well, I know if I relax, I'm going to fall asleep, and I'm not doing God's will. So he brought me here. I tell the flesh, well, I'm sorry, you profit me nothing. I'm going in the spirit, because in the spirit, I cannot get tired. So actually, I practice. I said, okay, fresh out, and I'm getting in the spirit. Actually, I feel myself getting out there and start praying. But don't think the devil's just going to leave you alone because you just say you're getting out. Yeah. You need to stay alert. If he comes back and says, excuse me, I am in the spirit. Amen? The words that I have spoken, see, again. This is from John 6:63. He said, the Spirit alone gives eternal life. The flesh is no help at all. So why should I hang out with the flesh? It's not going to help me. But the words that I have spoken, this word, they are spirit and filled with life. You see? It's powerful. The Lord was like telling me, do you actually know how the word of God is so powerful? Did you hear the story of the nun? I think it's a brother Sadhu who told that story. It's a true story. This nun, she decided, you know, God has said in his word that I do not live by bread alone, but only every word that comes out of his mouth, so I'm going to practice it. So she wakes up one morning, she said, I'm going to have a cup of tea, sit down with the Lord and read the word of God. At noon, do the same. Evening, do the same. To this day, she has not eaten. And she looks great. She looks healthy. She just started to test the word of God. But now, don't be going to do this if God has not called you to do that. I'm not saying, okay? You say, well, I'm going to do. You know, you have to be sensitive. But this is an example of how the word of God is really, really powerful. Amen? Are you having any problem in your life? Are you disappointed? What does the word of God tells you? What does the word of God say about the problem you are facing? There is nothing you can go through that is not here. The answer is all here. You know, when you are down, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Yeah. So when you don't feel smiling, maybe start with a fake smile, you know? Faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. Where I can say, it can, if you start doing something, you say, oh, I don't feel like smiling, but Lord, you said, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Let me practice. The more you practice it, because this is not lie, it's truth, you will start feeling joy because you are believing what the word of God says. Amen?
Amen.
How about fear? You know, especially with people with spiritual eyes open. Sometimes we can see things that are terrifying. I mean, people who see in the spirit, sometimes we don't understand them. Right, my sister? Because you can see terrifying images if you're seeing. Because if your eyes are open, you're just not going to see angels and Jesus. Sometimes the Lord will allow you to see the other side. And those demons, they can be terrifying. But hey, what does the word of God say? Greater is Jesus in you than the devil in this world. Amen. So what's to fear? Even if this demon just looks like it's touching up the sky, the greater one in you is stronger. So do not give in to the fear, but start telling whatever you are facing, hey, God has not given me a spirit of fear, but of power. What? Power, love, and a sound mind or self-control. Well, you have no choice but to believe, because this isn't true. What I'm seeing is just an image out there, but this is true. So, those of you who have spiritual eyes open, you start seeing some things that are terrifying you. Trust in God. It's not only those with spiritual eyes open. Sometimes, you know, we face big circumstances in our lives. You look at your bank account, it's empty, and by the end of the month, you don't know how you're going to pay the bill, and fears start coming up, and you start imagining yourself, oh, they're going to evict me. No, you're going to a wrong place. Hey, who is your provider? God. He shall supply what? All my needs according to his riches and glory. My goodness, God is word. So you start saying and believing it, you know what? He's going to provide. Just make sure you are dedicated to him. Because one thing he told me, your dedication is what's important. Do not worry if in your family they are not saved. Do not worry if at your work things are going wrong. Dedicate yourself to me. Be faithful and watch. What am I going to do? Because the prayers of the righteous, they accomplish much. And actually the word of God says that God is attentive to the prayers of the righteous, and his eyes are on them. Can you imagine? Father God, the creator of the heavens and the earth. The one sitting on a throne who holds everything in his hands actually talks about the earth is his footstool. I mean, his feet must be so big. Oh, Abba, I can't wait to see you. Wow! I mean, the mighty one.
He can help me today.
Hallelujah! I receive it in Jesus' name. So know who you follow.
Amen.
Our God is mighty. Amen. Our God is big. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Believe in what he says.
Yes.
Because it is true. He is not a man that he lies. Not a son of man that he changes his mind. Never changing his mind. He doesn't say something today and then tomorrow say, maybe, I don't know. No. Trust what he says. Amen.
Hallelujah.
So I'm about to cross. But let's read Isaiah. Can somebody read for me? Therese, can you help me read it? And Isaiah 40, 25 through 31. I want you to grab. I mean, this is simple. It's not something that is so deep that we cannot get. So Isaiah 40. Verse 25 through 31. Hallelujah. Mighty, mighty God. Thank you, Jesus.
To whom then will you liken me, that I should be as his equal, says the Holy One?
Mm.
Lift up your eyes on high and see who created these stars.
Hallelujah.
The one who leads forth their host by number. He calls them all by name.
Mm.
Because of the greatness of his might and the strength of his power, not one of them is missing.
Yes.
Why do you say, O Jacob, and assert, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and the justice due me escapes the notice of my God? Do you not know? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, does not become weary or tired.
Yes.
His understanding is inscrutable. Keep going.
To 31.
He gives strength to the weary, and to him who lacks might, he increases power.
Yes.
Though youths grow weary and tired and vigorous, young men stumble badly, yet those who wait for the Lord will gain new strength.
Amen.
They will mount up with wings like eagles.
Yes.
They will run and not get tired. They will walk and not become weary.
Thank you, Jesus. Do you hear? They're talking about God. He does not get weary. He does not get tired. This is the one we hope in. This is the one we trust in. Are you in a situation when you feel like it's too much? The warfare is so intense. I cannot go on. You have a God who never grows tired. Lean to him. Tell him, Abba, I want to come in your arms. Hey, he provides strength in here, he says.
Mm-hmm.
He will give you strength. Tell him, I'm tired. Mm-hmm. And he says, my strength, they will lift you up. We just have to learn. And to learn to practice this word, we have to run to him because he is powerful. When I was reading this scripture, I couldn't believe, I mean, he knows all the stars and by number and by names. He knows all the hair on your head, the numbers of them. He knows how many have fallen off your head this morning when you were combing your hair. How powerful is our God?
Amen.
He is so powerful. And he says, 31, but those who hope or who wait on the Lord, they will renew. He will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagle. When you feel tired, you start feeling like you are gaining strength. You feel like it's flying, right? You will run and not grow weary. You will walk and not faint. I have practiced this scripture. So sometimes we do things and sometimes we forget. But the Lord was reminding me this week, hold on to my word because my word is powerful. There are times I was really, really tired and I didn't have time to take a nap. For me, if I take a nap, it's going to be at least an hour because I sleep a few hours. I need to take like an hour nap so I can be praying powerful at night. But we were going to go to the streets, and I had like 30 minutes. And I said, okay, hey, let's find a scripture that can give me strength. And I just look at this Isaiah 40 and verse 31. Those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. I said, oh, hey, let's wait on the Lord. So I find some soft music. And then I went to him. I said, well, this is what your word said. If I wait on you, I will get new strength. So I stretched my hands, I closed my eyes, and I started meditating on him. And strength started coming in. The weariness started going out because I was believing in the word of God. I'm telling you, when I got out of that 30 minutes of prayer, I felt like I slept like a week. I went downtown, I was filled with energy, but it was because I practiced the word of God and I was believing that it is true. So what I'm telling you today is that there is nothing too hard for the Lord. There's nothing that is impossible. His word is mighty and powerful. There is nothing that you are facing in your life that is too hard for him to do. Trust in the Lord. Believe in his word. There are answers here from anything you can face. There's nothing you cannot find here. Answers are all in the word of God. If we can always learn to wait, because sometimes he does not answer right away. If we can always remember that God is faithful, he guarantees that he will fulfill his word because he is trustworthy to deliver everything he has promised you, and he's faithful in all he does. You know, the Bible says even when we are faithless, he remains faithful. That's our God. That's the God we serve. So my sister, my brother, I'm encouraging you this morning, hold on to this word. Do not try to save yourself. Do not try to figure out, come up with a way to do things. You know, there are things that you don't have to really pray for because it's common things, you know. If you see a candy in a store, you don't have to go ask God, if can I take it without paying? You already know what to do. You cannot just go steal, you know. But there are things you don't just go and figure out yourself. You have to ask God. And if you don't hear from him, you know, the thing I have been experiencing or seeing people, how the enemy works in people, is he wants people to move fast. Somebody told me a few weeks ago, said, we have to do this and we have to do it fast. I knew when when the devil is talking, because he wants you to push something fast without even praying and wait on the Lord. So I said, no, excuse me. God has not taught me anything like that, so I'm not joining, I'm not participating. I have to wait on the Lord. So I encourage you, wait on the Lord. Apply this sharp, two-edged sword. Hold it. It's not going to work if you have just knowledge of the word. You have to swing it. You have to pierce through everything you're going through and watch what God can do. You are loved. You are strong and mighty, because the greater one that lives in you is stronger. Hold on to him. It will get shaky. God did not promise it's going to be easy. There are many who are called, but only a few are chosen. So hold on. When you endure to the end, the prize is so amazing. You want to receive that reward when God will be saying, well done, my good and faithful servant. Can you imagine when he holds your hand and you're walking through the streets of heaven with Jesus, looking at the mansions, the waterfalls, the bird flying, calling your name, the flowers singing? God is so good. And Jesus, the most amazing thing. And Father God, oh, I can't wait to sit down in his hands and hug him. I want to encourage you. Fix your eyes on him. He's faithful. Amen?
Amen.
God bless you, and remember to smile and be happy.